Hello everyone, welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia. I am Assistant Professor Amrita Harjani. Today we will study about the topic Performance Management and Overview. This is one of the specialization subject topic, that is Performance Management and Career Planning, in third year TY BMS, fifth semester. What exactly this concept performance management means? In human resource management, performance appraisal, career planning, performance management plays an important role. When we are talking of achieving the objectives and results in an organization, we should know how to monitor the regular basis performance of each and every employee in the organization. Performance management is a continuous process. It results into flowing and proper communication between employer and employee. It results into supporting the achievement of goals, mission, vision and objectives of any organization. What is expected from the employees, whatever the objectives that is being set by the organization, goals identification and providing and timely feedback to the employees in the organization. Based upon that, the reviewing of the results are done so that whatever the gap is there between the output and the input in the organization is being set. So this is what an overview in brief introduction about the performance management was. There are certain key elements and the features or characteristics about the performance management topic. First of all, it measures the output of the delivered performance. What exactly is being expected from the employees is being clarified in this concept. The expectations from the organization side, that is the employers, as well as the employees' expectations are supposed to be clearly expressed in the targeted, which is being set by the organization. It is generally being considered as an agreement between the requirements of the roles, as well as if any kind of improvement is being required in the performance or any kind of development plans like training is supposed to be given, all such kind of outputs are being measured here. Second is all about, it is being concerned with the inputs and the values. Where I'm saying inputs means it, I'm talking about the KSA, that is knowledge, skills and abilities, as well as the behavior which is being required by any candidate or any employee in the organization. The proposed prospective candidate's input are being concerned with the values, that is the output, the expected results. Being an performance management, it is being considered as a continuous as well as the flexible process. When I am saying a continuous means, I am talking about managing them as an acting as in partners within a framework. Equal partnership is required from both the end. In case of any uncertainty, in case of any strategies that are being required to be formulated, if performance management is a flexible process, we can change the strategies on the spot and the results are desired results can be achieved easily. Performance management is based upon the principles of management concept. It is not at all a contract, or it is not at all being considered to be as relying basically only upon control or coercion. No, nothing at all being forced over here, but it is being based upon the contract or agreement, because here the management is being done with the help of contract or mutual agreement between both the parties rather than the management by command. Performance management, it focuses upon the future. It is a forecasting element. Here planning and improvement both are being focused. How to improve the performance of the employees gradually? What are the planning to be done? How the activities are to be processed in any organization? A continuous evaluatory procedure is being formulated here in the organization. Over gradually, over the period of time, it requires whatever the improvements are being required and whatever the conversation is there between the managers and individuals regarding the performance and about the individual development phase, all these are being focused upon here. Now, certain components which are very important in this subject that we will be discussing today, that is all about performance management related, performance planning. Whenever I am saying about the planning, means I am talking about something that is going to happen in future, about the forecasting. So performance planning is jointly being done by the appraisee, and also it is including all the reviews about in the beginning of the performance session. Here, whatever the targets that are being set, that within the year, along with the budget that is to be performed, mutually being decided by the reporting officer and the employee, which is being finalized. So performance planning is being done accordingly. Next is all about performance appraisal and review. A systematic review, timely review about the performance, about the evaluation of the all the employees in the organization. It is generally twice a year, mid reviews and the annual reviews are being done in the end of the financial year. Here the self rating is very important, self filling is very important in the self appraisal form is being given, in which they will describe about their all the achievements gradually over the period of time, whatever they have done in the quantifiable terms which can be measured. Once all these things are being done, reviews are being done, the final ratings are then being provided by the appraiser. And then it is being quantifiable and the measurable achievements are being assessed and the feedback is being given upon them. About the feedback on the performances, here the counseling is being required and the facilitation on the performances. If the appraiser is being evaluated based upon his performance over a period of time, yearly or mid reviews, the motivation plays here an important role. If the employee is performing really well, as compared to the expected results or whatever that is being expected, then they should be appraised. Here a good counseling should be given if they are not performing well, and training programs should be arranged for those employees so that whatever the gaps that are being seen in their performances, if the actual performances that are being not done, so that in overall, you know, productivity can be improved and we can improve their knowledge, so that gap is being filled up later on. So counseling and facilitation both should be there for the employees. We should even reward a good performance. Here when we are talking of an overall gradually the whatever the performance that is being done overall by any employee, if we find that yes, employee is doing really good, motivation in the form of rewards, bonus or any kind of monetary, non-monetary rewards, both plays here an important role. If this thing is done, their self-esteem, the achievement level which is being done by them will be motivated on a larger scale. Next is about the performance improvement plans. Here the new deadlines for any employee for setting up completely a new fresh set goals should be established for any employee, and that should be clearly communicated about what areas improvement are to be expected by an employee, so that they should complete it before the deadline which is assigned to them, so that the improvement is being seen. Now here there will be an plan this which is being developed for improving the performance. It is jointly being planned by appraisee as well as the appraiser. Both should mutually approve it. Next is all about the potential appraisal. Here it forms a basis for both lateral as well as the vertical movement of employees. Whatever the potential any employee is having, what sort of techniques in terms of assessment as well as the competency mapping, by implementing both these, the critical inputs for succession plan as well as job rotation will be given over here, so that whatever they are supposed to achieve in the future will be assessed. Next is all about the various aims and objectives that is being set for the performance management. Now when we are talking of the certain objectives, targets that are to be achieved, here in terms of performance management, we should make sure that it helps in achieving the employee's knowledge and skills. apart from this, whatever the standards that are being set by the organization, employees will try to achieve it. So they will become a more career oriented towards it. And to achieve the efficiency in the organization, it is very important that they are performing the task in a right way, so that the efficiency will result into evaluating their performance. Because if once they are performing efficiently in the organization, we can encourage them towards more tasks that to be performed by them. Here, to involve them in the decision making, giving them empowerment so that they become the part of the organization, their motivation level will increase. Along with this, communication plays an important role. There should be a two-way system of communication between both supervisor and the employee, so that whatever the clarifications of the roles, duties, tasks, responsibilities that is being given to them, it should be clear at the beginning itself. This will result into giving a quick feedback about their performances, and continuous training and coaching is also required. Whatever the barriers that are being identified during this entire stage, it is very important that with the help of coaching and a gradual development interventions should be implemented, so that these barriers are being overcome on a later stage. We will even focus upon various strategies that is to be formulated with the help of performance management in future, so that we become a competitor, a strong competitor in the environment, in the future scaling should be there. When we are talking of a personal growth, when we are talking of the career of the employees, this becomes very clear if we implement a good performance appraisal and management scale, because this will lead to a clear-cut path that which employee is very active, which employee is proactive, which employee is reactive in terms of performing their task. Next is all about importance of performance management. If we are looking after into a future, that yes, this is the set target that we want to achieve. Yes, this is the key elements that being a potential leader that we want to set as an image of our organization, performance management will play an important role. Whatever the training strategies are to be created, so that whatever the drawbacks or the gaps that are being identified, training programs will help them, all the employees, to improve their own efficiency, their own KSA element, that is the knowledge, skill and ability element, so that whatever the opportunities they are having in the future, they perform it very effectively. This even clarifies about all the opportunities which are happening in the organization. If there is a communication gap or any kind of lack of productivity or lack of understanding between the employer and employee, which is affecting the productivity and the confidence of the employees or employers, this will make them very clear. And the strong feedback is being given. This will clear cut give you an opportunity about the drawbacks of the organization also, and whatever the problems that are being faced by the employee side also. So we can exchange the feedbacks with the management about the frustrations or any kind of concerns that are being faced by the employees. If this thing is being done, the entire feedback session plays an important role in any organization. So whatever the gradual improvement is required for any organization, that will become very clear. Here, employee retention is also increasing. Employee retention means how long your employee is staying back in the organization. Whatever the rewards that are to be given for any employee, the motivation part, we should even think that if because of lack of recognition, if any employee is leaving the job, they should be appreciated for their hard work, because the amount of time that any employee is spending in the organization is very long. So gradually, along with the family, along with their home, equal amount of time they are spending at their workplace also. If any employee is working really hard, appreciation plays an important role towards their motivation part. So if they feel satisfied from their job, automatically the retention level will be very high. It boosts, even it encourages even the engagement of the employees, because they will feel part of the organization and they will be effectively working towards the productivity part of the organization, and they will equally contribute towards the organization goals. The scope of management is very wide. It is not at all narrow, not only from the organization point of view, but all other stakeholders, whatever the employees, suppliers, customers, government, all of them will be playing an important. It is consisting a broad organizational framework, because here the provision is not only limited to the employer and employee side, but continuous development of the levels of the employee is being seen with the help of various programs like training programs, developmental programs. We can increase the knowledge of the employees. So all of them are working together to achieve the set results of the organization. And whatever the data is being gathered and the appreciation process which is being done annually, or mid reviews that are being done, so rewards will even, you know, motivate them. Certain preconditions or prerequisites are there for the performance management. Commitment level from the top management is very essential, because a good culture of the organization will result into creating a vibrant environment for the employees. The mission, vision, goals should be clearly defined. A proper transparent communication should be there, so that this will not only increase the performances, but even the participation and the fairness and the consistency of the employees will be very high. And along with this, you know, the training part, the rewards part will be, you know, that should be the part of the organization. What are the best practices that can be followed for any performance management? It helps in identifying the goals. We should know that what is to be achieved in future, how it can be done, in which way we should be done. So whatever the guidelines are there for our advantage, we should be very clear with this. Describing the roles, defining it very clearly. We should even monitor the progress towards our targets. Coaching if required for the employees, those who are not working very nicely. If we require any kind of mentoring or coaching, we can give them. We can even organize different workshops so that the cross-functional trainings should be given to motivate their individuality and making them confident towards the futuristic goals. So this was all about the performance management. Thank you, everyone.